So here we are doing the operators in the PHP, and in the same series I am here going to demonstrate how the logical operator works in PHP. So in order to do that, I'm just going to create a file here with the name of say logical and .php to the extension of this. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to copy all these contents from here, copy. And here I'm just going to paste it, and here I'm giving it the title, say logical operators in PHP. And what I'm going to do, and just these codes are not required here, so I'm going to delete all these codes from here. And this is to show the logical operators in PHP. I'm just going to minimize this here, and here I'm just going to write code for this. Say I'm just going to take a variable, say x this time, and to this I'm initializing a value of 100, and I'm taking another variable, say y, and to this I'm initializing a value of say 50. So how to use the logical operator, first operator, that is AND operator. So in order to do the AND operator, I'm here using the if statement. What exactly is the if statement? That we will also learn in the coming video. But I'm just, in order to demonstrate that this operator, I'm using the if statement. If you have idea about the if statement, then you will be able to better to understand. And what is exactly the if statement, that also we will learn in the coming videos. So here I'm using if. And here in the body of if, I am writing that if variable x is equal to say 100, and I am using AND operator here, and variable y is equal to say 50. Okay, so here I am just going to write the body for this if, and here I am writing echo. You have done. Okay, and put the semicolon here to terminate this. And to see the save the changes here, and to see the difference, you just go to this browser screen, and here you see the logical.php file is there, and you see this is showing that this will show the logical operator in PHP, and is showing us the output as you have done. Now, because of the reason AND operator is doing over here, and it will return true. Now the condition is matched, that's why it's executing the body of if. Now here we are checking that x is equal to 100 and y is equal to 50, means condition at the left side of AND and the right side of the AND operator is true, so it's returning true in both cases, so it's displaying this. So we just change this value to something else and see what's going to be happen here. And here we save the changes, and here we go refresh, nothing is going to be happen over there. It means to say that the condition at the left side is true, but condition on the right side is not true, because the value of y is equal to 60. So that's why the body inside the if will not get executed here. Okay, so body inside the if is not going to be executed there. So that's why it's not displaying you have done over here. If we change this value to say equal to 60, say 50, then it will work for us. The means condition at both the side is equal to true, so it will display and execute the body of if here in our case. Similarly, here we are going to use the OR operator. So in order to do that, so simply copy this content from here to here and paste it here, and here use OR operator. So in order to use the OR operator, we can use this symbol, or we can write OR here. So save the changes here, and again refresh here, And what you can do, you can write here echo, and here I'm just using the br element to break the line, and put a semicolon here. So save the changes here and refresh it. You will see you have done or you have done. But in case I'm just changing the value here equal to say 60, so what's going to be happen? So here we refresh. The first is here, the value is true at this side but false at this side. So it means to say that AND operator will only works, only returns true when condition at both the left side as well as the right side of the AND operator is true. Only then it will work. But in case of OR, if you see it's doing here, you have done. It means if when the value at the left hand side or either the value on the right hand side, one of them is true, then it will return as true, and it will return false only when value at the both the side is false. So if I change this value to 101 over here, save changes and see the difference, and it will, you will see that it's even not working here. So this is how we just can use OR operator. So next is coming at the XOR operator. We can use here, we simply have to write XOR, or we copy this contents from here to here and paste it here, and here you have to write XOR operator. Save the changes and you see the thing is doing over here. If we change this 100 here, refresh it over here, this is done over there, this is done there. But what this will XOR operator, the difference between the OR and the XOR operator is that if both the sides are true, in this case if both the sides are true, even that XOR operator will work. But in case XOR operator, if both the sides are true, that is left hand side and right hand side are true, then it won't work. So make the changes here. So I'm just putting 50 here and save it, and you see here the result. The first two are working but XOR is not working because both the sides are true. In this case here, it in this case left hand side is true and the right hand side is true, so it's working. XOR operator is working, and the AND operator is also working because it will work only in if left hand side and right hand side is true. But and in the OR case, if it will work only if one of the side is true, then it will even work. Here in case both the sides are true, so it's again working. But in case of XOR, it will work only when one of the side is true. If both the sides are true, then it won't work. Yes. Similarly, then there is coming as a you can use, instead of writing here AND, you can use this operator, this double ampersand sign you can use, and this will work as AND operator. Same, it will return the result here. You can write AND or you can use this operator. Instead of OR, you can use double pipe sign. Here you will get the pipe sign here on your keyboard, and this is pipe sign. You have to use double pipe sign, so it is just like of your OR operator. Save the changes and you see the difference over here. Okay, so this symbol can be used as AND operator, or you can simply write AND, or you can use this symbol for OR operator, or you simply write here OR. And here in the case of, then we are left with the last is NOT. Control C, and here we just go copy with and paste it here, and here we see it will work only if we say make the changes to this, and here we write x not equal to 100. So save the changes here, and you see nothing is going to be happen because it will return true only if x is not equal, if x is not true. But here in this case x is equal to 100, so that's why it's not working. If we change the value of x over here, say we put it 90, so what's going to be happen? It will work for us as we see that x is not equal to 100. That's true, so it's working in our case. So this is how we can use the logical operators in PHP. That's all for now. See you in the next.